Last game of the week, Brad. We got Dallas minus 7.5, according to Bovada, at the New York Giants.
Ooh, a division game, 7.5. Let's go New York, baby.
Really?
Yeah, I think that New York can give them a run for their money.
Surprised.
For sure.
I'm surprised at that pick. I'm going to take Dallas. I don't like betting against the division home underdog there. And that extra half point's not great either. That's 7.5 instead of the 7. But
no, that's why I'm taking New York. Did I misunderstand what's happening here?
Yeah, yeah. What? No, you're taking New York. Yeah, I'm taking Dallas. Yeah, that's I just.
But New York is our 7.5 point underdogs.
Yeah, that's
home.
Correct. Dallas minus 7.5.
Right. Yeah. Okay.
I'm just saying I don't love the half point, but I'm gonna swallow it anyway.
Got it. Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah. I'll take Dallas here, coming off the bye week. I think fantasy wise, Dak Prescott, Ezekiel Elliott, Amari Cooper all have really big games. Michael Gallup will have a nice game. He's a start. I don't like anybody else for Dallas. You got the Giants, not Daniel Jones, but yes to Saquon Barkley. I think Sterling Shepard would be a decent start this week if he plays. If he doesn't, look at Darius Slayton. And then Evan Engram is a start this week. So there you go, Brad. There's a full week of games. We actually agreed on quite a bit this week. San Francisco and Green Bay are my two favorite bets. I believe they're yours as well. If we did a pick six this week, we would have to kind of fight over some stuff. I think we'd have a little bit of a tough time because, Miami, we both agree on Miami, but I don't love it.
Right.
Chicago, maybe. Yeah, it's going to be an interesting one. Maybe I'll post the picks on Twitter. But like I said, we are disbanding the Pick Six podcast. The juice is not worth the squeeze. For some reason, people don't like gamblers when they're at 63%. You know, maybe it's like people don't think that 63% is good because it sounds like if you got a 63% on a test, it's not good.
Right,
but that is phenomenal.
And that may be it. Yeah, but those who know, like that's fantastic.
I've been doing this for 5 years. That's the whole reason I started this podcast. Like everything, this whole business started as me because I was hitting 60% in gambling and thinking like, holy crap, you know, I bet you people will want to get my picks. And I thought I would sell the picks for like $5, you know, a pop or something like that because other people are selling the picks for like $1,000. It's like, just get the volume. Nobody wants them.
Right.
Nobody wants them.
Right.
They tell me, go back. Go back and do something with your life.
62% is fantastic.
It's amazing, and this is our second year doing it. It's and this is my fifth year personally, kind of on that track. I've only finished under 60% one season, and that was like 2015-ish, and I was at like 57 or 59% or something like. So I've never finished under the pay line in my whole like kind of betting career doing this. It's just I just can't believe that I can't get more traction, especially with the audience and all that stuff. But that's just me complaining. It has nothing to do with the audience. We love you guys. Thanks for tuning in. And by the way, you know, for people concluding this in the YouTube, please give us a subscribe. Please give us a like. The sooner we get to our YouTube partnership, we can actually make these videos more interactive. You know, check me out on Twitter. I'm at @TFS_Sean. Check Brad out on Twitter. Just kidding. He doesn't have Twitter. He hates social media, and I can't blame him. But yeah, we'll be out and be back next week. Also, depending on when you check these videos, I will have a deep dive, a game plan prediction in the upper right-hand side, so check those out as well. And for our podcast audience, I only do the game dives on YouTube, so once again, the channel is youtube.com/theunderdog. Thanks, everybody, and we will catch you next week. All right, brother.